If I was a Korok and I was on top of the house and my friend was Craig's house, it's kind of far, right? I'm like,
yeah.
I need to get to my friend. He's over there. How would you do it?
That's a hell of a distance.
Do I have access to our car?
Yeah, but it's in the style of Tears of the Kingdom. So it's like...
I think your car kind of almost already is.
Yeah, but it's like, it's very boxy looking.
Mm. Right.
Yeah.
So is it open? Open concept car?
Yeah, like you can just tear the pieces off if you want.
Like when people take their doors off Jeeps?
Mm-hmm.
Cool.
Well, no, it's exactly like Zelda.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, you see, I am not very good at steering the cars in Zelda.
Mm-hmm.
You got that little thing. Yeah. I'm terrible at it. So I think I'd just pick you up.
You just carry me the whole way?
I'd just walk to Craig's house.
The whole... Oh, my God. What if you die on the way there? Okay, every person who lives in our city is a moblin.
That's a lot of
moblins. And a bokoblin.
Oh my god, that's a lot of people.
And a boblin. Yeah. But they're not like all aggroed on you yet. They have to see you. And all of their cars, they also have built cars.
Okay, that's impossible.
So you still walking?
Can I fly?
I don't know, can you?
I suppose I could. We have fans in the house. I could.
You just take fucking that one?
I just rip it off, yeah.
Well, shake. All right. You've only got like two batteries.
Oh, God. There's no way we're getting to Craig's house on two batteries.
Nope.
Yeah, it's unfortunate.
All right. I go into the depths.
There you go.
I mine for those little things.
All right. You build some fucking... What do you build then?
No, I mine until I get those the little things that you can turn in for more batteries.
Oh, you just get more?
I get more batteries.
All right.
But then I get sidetracked by Pose. And
I just get left there for weeks.
You're there for weeks.
That's all right. That's cool. Yeah. That's cool.
That's my experience so far.
Yeah.
Those little Pose. There's like one little speck in the distance. I'm like, I gotta get him.
I have to get that speck.
I gotta get him.
I need it. Yeah.
The amount of times I'm in the depths. And I'm like, oh, I want to find another little light route thing. And I'm going around, and then I'm like, oh, I see one. And I get there, and it's one I already have. I'm like, shit. Oh, who's calling you?
It was my mom for 2 seconds.
Oh. Oops.
I was going to be like, you're on the podcast.
Anyway.
It's a CP day today, guys.
It is CP.
It's going to be really fun. Tomorrow we're going to Disneyland with... Colton and Sari and you and Mia and Emma, and we've been planning this out for a little while. It's going to be a super fun time, but I don't go to sleep like a normal person.
Yeah.
So I stayed up really late and then woke up really early, so I'm really tired today so that I go to bed at like 9. 3:30 hit today, and I'm like, I'm falling asleep right now. But it's good, because once the sun sets, I'll randomly get a bunch of energy, and I'll be good. But it's just going to be kind of a chill podcast.
Yeah.
It's going to be like...
lounge portion.
Yeah, exactly. I worked a little bit today, and then the rest of it I spent playing Zelda and taking care
of the
baby.
You have all of the people now, though.
Yep. I'm at the end. I don't know.
He's racing to the end.
I... have to save her.
Oh, Craig, it's okay.
I appreciate the hustle, though.
Yeah.
I fucking respect it.
He's feral. It's all he feral. Talks about.
Yeah.
I can't. Jack and I, once 10 p.m. hits, Jack and I are sending each other the most fucking... what did I call it? The
brain
most,
rot.
Yeah, like brain like rot. Shipper trash,
yeah.
Awful, and we're both just like.
Yesterday, after we finished Witchlight,
I have a Pinterest board with like over 100 pins.
Yeah,
it's fucking rough right now. All right, it's the only thing I know. I'm sorry.
No, you're fine. Get it out.
No, I'm done. I didn't have any more than that.
Yesterday, we were in the car after we finished Witchlight, and he put on this song. And I thought he was trying to relate the song to characters
from Witchlight. I did, but I did, though. But I did.
But he was talking about Link and Zelda.
Yeah. Okay.
He didn't say...
Look. I don't even know he was talking
about Link and Zelda. He just said, in the game.
I did.
But we had just finished playing Witchlight.
I don't need... I don't need to be called out from everybody. So,
and then through context clues, I was able to figure out he was talking about he wasn't talking about anyone in the game. He was talking about Link and Zelda.
This is definitely not why it's been difficult to sleep at night. I have to be like, I'm gonna think about something fucking else, and I just can't. I just fucking can't. And I'm like, all right, we'll just hyperfixate on this until I fall asleep, and that's what happens every time.
For an hour and a half. It's all right. I feel the same, but not on your level. I'm like, oh, they have a little house, but there's only one bed. How strange.
Look, there's that.
Jacob's like, there's only one bed.
That sent me to emotional devastation, all right? I'm not going to go all into it because we're going to have an episode like last week, but I plan on making a video about all of this at some point just so I can get it all out. But I just want to say that this has been a... I guess what I realized maybe a few days before the game came out is that this affected me a lot more as a kid than I realized.
Yeah.
And it has been with me for a long time. And it all fucking opened up again. And I'm like,
It's again.
Yeah.
What? You're like, yeah. Wait, is that or is it when he smiles? I feel more like the second one. So...
No. Okay. I'm sorry.
I tweeted about it yesterday, and I was like, "I learned a lot. I've been learning a lot about myself." So, I'm not gonna splay it all out here because it's a bit cringe and a bit much, but
and it's for a video upcoming.
Exactly. So, yeah. All you guys need to know is that I'm emotionally devastated by Link and Zelda, but that's it.
There's something there.
There is.
It is weird. The only one, but.
It's not weird, it's cute, and it's amazing, and it makes me happy. All right, we got to talk about something else.
You asked the Twitter for questions, right?
I always have to... They're making me work.
I'm tired of this, Grandpa. I'm so sorry if you guys can hear us chewing on these Starbursts. It's terrible.
Read one of these questions so I can finish the Starburst.
They're a wee bit stale. Nails on each other. It's the same thing. I will say, though, there's a comment I wanted to address. God, I think it was on the... We streamed so many times this week. I'm fairly certain it's on the Questa one-shot we just did.
Uh-huh.
And they said that they wish that Emma would be in a campaign.
Oh, yeah.
Emma is in a campaign coming up.
Yeah.
So just wait.
Oh yeah, my god. It's gonna be so awesome.
Whole thing through.
Her character idea is pretty cool too.
It is.
It's very good.
It's very good.
Mine's very cool.
Very nice.
I really like mine.
I really like yours.
Okay. Colleen asked, "Hey guys, if your Wild Beyond the Witchlight characters had a smartphone, what would be their lock screen? Hope you all are well. Also, thank you for constantly calling my cues amazing." Well, they just are. So that's also just a good question.
Mine's a cat.
Is it? It's Titus.
Yeah, probably a cat.
Tara's phone is broken.
And probably the screen's
cracked. Have you seen Jack's screen?
Yeah.
That's what her phone looks like. That makes a lot of sense. Just, if she's like, look, and you're like, I can't see anything. She's like, oh, well, sorry. it's probably... She just showed me.
I'll send it to you, Craig. You can't put it on... You can't, but...
Babs Tar. Can you describe it for the audience, please? Because they're not going to get to see... Yeah, you got to do it. You say it on the podcast, so it has to be explained.
Do you... It's a tiefling lady who is not clothed, spitting into a man's mouth.
Who is blindfolded.
Who is blindfolded.
Oh, my God. That checks out. That checks out.
My thunder's blessing.
It's being airdropped to you.
It is being airdropped to me.
Babs Tar, everyone, go support her on her Patreon.
Oh my god! Whoa!
And
you know, I have to do the zoom and enhance. Like, what is that? God damn, Babs Tar.
Yeah,
I know.
God damn.
Every time you see it, you're just like, wow.
She's a bark Sheesh. A little bit.
She'll send you stickers if you pay her enough. It's good.
You have lots of stickers.
I do.
They cover all of our devices. There's just I'll just turn over a charger and I'll see a hot woman and I'll be like, damn.
Yeah.
I think Tara has one of two things. It's either like It's actually probably like aesthetic slideshow of nature scenes. And if not that, then like landscape, like water deep aesthetic, you know, it'd be like that. But you could barely see it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's like she climbed a mountain and then in the distance, very mm-hmm. small, is yeah. water deep. She's like, mm-hmm. I took this.
Yeah.
I went mm-hmm. for a 12-mile jog mm-hmm. up a mountain.
I just felt motivated to do it.
Yeah. Probably that. Probably that.
It's good.
Makes a lot of sense.
Yeah.
And yours is Titus?
Probably. Yeah. Some boomer shit.
Yeah.
It's a selfie of you holding Titus.
Yeah, yeah,
so
but it's
you're
like,
you're like yeah. 20% of it.
Titus all the
is in it. Yeah.
And
yeah.
the rest of it's just probably stock.
Yeah. I'd be curious to know what Dreads is. I'm going to ask Mia right now.
There you go.
You guys have to talk about the next question, though.
I don't think Dread has a phone.
Probably not.
I think Dread was given a phone and very quickly lost the phone.
Yeah. Hello? Why are you playing music?
It's fucking funk.
It was some funk, yeah. The Magic by Witch Z? I've been listening to that shit. It's fucking good. Okay. Hey, comma, if it's not going to understand Dread. had a phone, what would her background be? This is a podcast question, and I'm really curious. I'm going to put we're curious.
I am also curious.
Yeah. Fuck yeah. The people are curious.
Mm-hmm, exactly. Yeah,
the fucking proverbial we.
Yeah. Some
bullshit. All in my hair.
Oh.
I cooked today, and I really was cooking in the trenches.
Yeah.
Everywhere.
What'd you cook?
Just some fucking like vegetable soup.
Vegetable soup.
Yeah, but I guess I was flinging shit around.
Was it tasty?
Yeah.
Good.
Yeah, we That's had cool. some just a little bit before we left.
Greg made us some food the other day, and mm-hmm. it was very good.
Yep.
Yeah, essentially the same thing, but water.
What water, yeah.
Yeah, it's about the same thing. It's about what I'm feeding them right now.
Good.
Feeding my goats.
my little goblins. Yeah. Some water real, with though. Celery.
The cooking heat is real. You could be cold as fuck. You start cooking, your body temperature shoots like a million degrees. Because you're moving and you're dealing with heat and you're doing a lot of shit. Mm-hmm. And it's just like, ugh. My mom, every single time she cooks, she'd be like, oh, I'm hot. We always make fun of her for it.
Yeah.
Uro asks, if your D&D characters had access to Spotify, what playlists would they have and what kind of music would be on it? It's funny you ask that. Spencer only has one for all of her characters.
I do.
So, I don't know. Go follow her on Spotify or something.
Yeah.
You have, like, all your character playlists on there. I have mine, too, but, like, mine's very unorganized and weird, so... Mm-hmm.
I don't know that that's the music that they would listen to. It's just songs that I think Farron's relate to them. Farron's probably, yeah. His is just sad teen boy music.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I think it goes into
and maybe
a point
Ari.
Of, yeah.
The Ari playlist is pretty fitting for her.
The one I made for Tara, I think, is music that she would like.
Huh. Well, then go follow Jacob on Spotify. Whatever. All right.
Sure. Have you made a branch playlist?
No.
What would Branch listen to?
Funk.
Funk.
That'd be very cool, but probably not. Honestly, I'm not sure. I mean, she probably was a country bumpkin at some point.
Yeah.
So probably just some garbage country.
Is Branch a Swiftie? I know she's not a country anymore, but...
probably not. I'm talking like spoons and washboards. kind of country. Talking Bayou.
It's got to be like, doo, doo,
yeah,
hey, like, yeah. It's got to sound like that.
Yeah.
Uh-huh, you can only go to a farmhouse to find it.
It's got a little bit of the...
It's underground.
Yeah, it's got some of that in there.
Some scat.
Yeah. But it's also... like throat singing at the same time. Yeah.
Oh, maybe where I came from is where Dread came from.
Oh, yeah. It makes sense for Dread, huh?
Mom.
No.
That's what we hear. That's what Dread hears. It's like the music box opens up and it's...
Yeah. Maybe she was in like a cult.
Honestly, we're going to find out.
We will.
I'm going to find out sooner or later. Probably later.
Yeah, probably later.
But soon.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
What?
This question. I thought it was real at first.
Okay.
Man, come on. Shawnee LaBolge asks, okay. Hey, y'all. All right. Hope you're having a great day.
Mm-hmm.
Can you... stop calling me. It's not my mom. It was somebody else. Somebody else. It wasn't my mom. Sorry. Hey, y'all. Hope you're having a great day. Can you remind us how Marcy's great-grandfather died?
Oh. Well, I don't think he's dead. He just lost, right?
He got lost at sea looking for Obama's last name.
Look at
it. Yeah. He's over here.
That is the last meme to go in the
and it never changed.
Never came out.
And he just stayed. He went in the bathroom for a while.
Oh God, Grandpa!
Grandpa, no.
That's how
he fell. Actually, yeah. He didn't die of old age. He sunk.
That's how we knew he was lost. One night we had a storm and it knocked off his photo on the ground. Yeah. And we're like, that's an ill omen.
Yeah, really. Mia said. For going back to Dread,
yeah.
A lock screen, a picture of Darwin, home screen, a picture of Charles, which are the rats.
one's black and gray, though.
Yeah.
One's a little gray. Rip. Yeah, rip.
That's like, so good.
It's got the little praying hands around it.
Yeah.
It's funny because both are all of Marcy's great grandparents, her actual great grandparents, not of this world anymore.
No. Your grandma's alive.
Oh, my grandma's alive. I meant to say father's.
And then great grand. No, my.
Do you have a grandma or a grandpa who's still alive?
Yeah.
You have a grandma, huh?
I have a grandma, a grandpa, and another grandpa.
Okay, well.
Wow.
My mom's mom died.
All right. But well, you know.
Yeah, I got all.
I don't know that. I've never met them.
Well, my grandpa lives in Portugal, and then you've met my dad's parents, like, one time. Who are you doing?
Oh, yeah, you're right. Yeah. It's because your family is so much younger than mine.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think my
grandma's in her 90s, and she's, like, still doing shit.
I think your parents are only probably, like, 15 to 20 years younger than my grandparents.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Mia also said she definitely has a TikTok account that has 3 followers where she's jumping around making gun noises with her mouth.
Oh my god. What's one that Jordan does?
No, I'm not.
Yeah.
Are the 3 followers our TikTok? Three?
Yeah, it's just the 3 of us.
Yeah. I'd follow her.
Spencer said, comma, are the 3 followers our characters? Question mark. Okay, then, also, because I'm a sucker for the How to Play series, Jacob, would you ever do a new How to Play series once when D&D finally releases in the future? I don't know, probably, maybe.
It'd be cool if you did that for, I mean, to what audience, I guess. But I would love to do the Fallout ones.
Oh, yeah.
Super cool.
Yeah, I really want to make archetypes for Fallout. Stuff. So, yeah that'd be cool. Just, like, to explain all that stuff. Mm-hmm. That would be fun, yeah. Yeah. Yeah, I mean, maybe, we'll see. I don't know. I remade it like a little while ago, like that Rogue one, like almost a year ago. And after making that, I just sort of realized I've sort of grown out of this type of content. It's like, it's fun and I like it and I like how it comes out, but it's kind of dated now. It's kind of, I don't know. I'm finding different ways to make videos. Mm-hmm. So Mia put, LOL, probably it's more likely that she has 4 followers and one of the accounts she made for Charles.
Oh.
Wow. Wow.
That's so good.
Rest in peace, little rat man.
Yeah. Really.
Ripped a little homie.
The diabetic DM asks, how do you go about naming your characters? I personally like to add secret references in my characters' names.
Mm. That's a good one.
I don't. I just go, these 2 normal names smashed together make a cool fantasy name.
Mm.
That's it. Or if I just find something weird that sounds cool, that's it. Yeah. I normally just sit there and just try to find what I want the name to sound like. And I'm like, and I'm like, that's a word. And I try to find a name in it.
Mm-hmm.
That's something I'm doing, something similar to what they said, is that there's like a hidden references, mm-hmm. like Lazarus is to songs, and one of my other characters, whatever, it's just
some branches to wood,
yeah. Mm-hmm. And then, but before I used to do colors,
because I used that's to cool.
like boil down the concept into like a sentence and then a color palette.
That's mm-hmm. cool.
So like Tiff is Tiffany for blue.
Oh, that's awesome.
And I used to play someone named Hickory. Mm-hmm. Was like a brown, and mm-hmm. then so on and so forth.
That's cool as fuck. I love mm-hmm. that.
I like names that mean something. Mm-hmm.
The end of it says, also for Spencer, is Ronan named after Laura Bailey and Travis Willingham's kid?
I don't think so. No.
Yeah. No. No, Ronan isn't. But I have in the past many a time said, man, that's a cool name.
It is a cool name.
Yeah. Yeah.
I also really like the name Travis.
Me too. But unfortunately, it's my cousin's name. So
it is.
Yep.
Rip all the good names.
Yeah.
Rip all the good names.
Yeah. Jordan the Bruh asks, hello, goobers. My question is, any advice for a high school graduate? Graduation is this Friday for me, and I have no plan. Help! I don't know. You're graduating, and you need a plan? You don't need to do anything to graduate. You just show up, and you just go, thanks. And then, I don't know, do something fun.
That's what you mean.
For graduation.
Yeah.
For graduation.
Yeah.
Celebrate. It's a big achievement.
I wish I would have. I did. I had a lot of fun when I graduated. I didn't have to really do much. Just behave, do your thing, and then go wild, because everybody's going to give you the excuse that it's okay because you graduated.
Yeah.
So make it fun. Don't make it something you can look back on and be like, oh, that sucked.
Yeah. Don't rush through it.
What are you laughing at? The fact that your class sang All Star?
We didn't sing All Star. Just every time someone would cross the stage, everyone would say ka-chow. Because that was like...
Your fucking class were like the meme lords, dude. Yeah. It'd be so funny. You guys wanted to... So every... Okay, at our school, at our high school, it was like... it was... We had like a choir thing. And
yeah.
The seniors, before they graduated, they would always sing like a song. Mm-hmm. So like, I don't know. We did some emo and moody. I don't remember what it was. Because we were the fucking nerds. Like, that was my class. But you guys were like, can we do All Star from Shrek?
They wouldn't let us.
Not All Star by Smash Mouth. All Star from Shrek.
Yeah.
And they were like, no.
Yeah, they said, no, you're not doing that.
You guys wanted to so bad. I remember that. Yeah. But everybody, somebody walked across the stage with ka-chow.
Everyone else would yell ka-chow, yeah.
That's so time. Awesome. That's great.
Yeah.
Emma's graduation was really funny because it was in 2020. Yeah. So it was, you know, it was bad. It was bad time. Or it's like 2021. I don't remember what it was. And regardless, it was peak COVID. And it was outside and everybody's all spread out and shit. And they had to sit. Like we were in like a theater, but they were outside, and the seniors are in a line. They're, you know, going to sing their little song, and through the whole song, mm-hmm. they don't have microphones because it's just outside. So they're very quiet because there's only like 20 of them because the school's really small.
Mm-hmm.
And a kid who is singing, his phone goes off in the middle of the song, and it's Among Us.
Yeah.
And Emma's right next to him, and I can see Emma just like, trying really hard not to laugh, and it doesn't stop the whole time. They're like, oh, like they're singing whatever their song is, and it's doon 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 boom boom doon doon doon, and everyone's like, what the fuck is going on? And it's louder than the kids, it goes the whole time.
That had to be intentional.
But it was really funny. Like, Emma was like, that was the funniest fucking thing ever. The fact that it didn't stop, it was like, don't, don't. It would end, and we'd be like, don't, don't, don't. It would just keep going. It was really funny. Yeah. Yeah.
Damn.
Wow. What was that for?
To hurry you up a little.
Wow, thanks.
Spur you on.
Gosh. Yep. You know what? Here.
Oh. Why you do that?
Hurry up.
Ow.
Hurry up.
A small tangent.
Hurry up.
Ow.
Yeah.
Colin's damn good as a DM.
He is.
There's a lot of moments
last game. Really is. Yesterday
that I'm like, you sure this is your first time? Because goddamn, it is.
I'm good. So impressed by him kid. Constantly.
You're good.
Really. I get lost in that game. And I turn and I'm like, "How you're popping off so hard, my guy."
Yeah.
Yeah. He does a really good job.
I'm very impressed.
I meant to text you this, but I guess I'm just going to say it here. Mm-hmm. The conversation that Branch had with Tara, you know, the one where it was after the combat, And they were in talking about that stuff. That was that was not only really, really cool, but it was cool to not only learn about Branch's character, but also it was cool to find that there was like a relation that Tara could have to her, and that there was something similar that happened, but it was like they're at different stages in their life, basically, which is really interesting. And there were a couple things that you said in there that went through Tara into Jacob, and I was like, so yeah, I that's why at the end of that I was like, I don't know what to do about this. I'm just gonna sit by this tree. I've been fucking sniped in the ass too many times during this game. I gotta get the fuck out of here.
I'm glad it had any kind of resonance. That's good.
Is this the question you
chose? I picked it for you.
Honk Shoe Pinworm Tribal Commander asks, God, what's y'all's favorite met archetype to play in Magic? Aggro, mid-range, Grixis, etc. And what is your least favorite, and why does it involve blue? It does involve blue. It does. My least favorite to play, it's probably, I've never played it because I hate it so much. So does it have to be one that I have played? What are the parameters of this question here?
What do you mean it's your favorite but you haven't played it?
No, least favorite.
Oh.
Least favorite. Like, least favorite to play.
They asked least favorite?
Is that... I'm sorry. What's y'all's favorite archetype and what's your least favorite?
Oh.
Yeah.
I see.
Well, my least favorite would probably be something I haven't played because I don't like it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So it, well, what and is it's that? Probably Pod. or it's like tokens. Like, I'm going to make a million goblins or a million squirrels. Yeah. Or it's... I'm going to put a 1-1 on this, and I'm going to make two more guys and put a 1-1 on them, and then their 1-1s are going to double, and then I'm going to make four more, and I'm going to put 1-1s on all of them, and then I hate that shit. I'm playing to get an infinite combo. Hate that too. It's just not the way I like to play the game. Mm-hmm. I don't play to just go, okay, I have all the cards, I win. I don't want to play Exodia. God damn.
What's your favorite?
My favorite way to play is probably... I don't know, probably aggro. Aggro, I like, what is it called? What is it called? It's when you have a lot of sacrifice.
Like aristocrats?
Aristocrats, thank you. That's a lot of fun. And I also really like playing... Whatever it is, when I get to play a card that makes another person have to play the game differently, and then I benefit from it. Don't know what that is.
Control?
Control, see, the part about control I don't like is going, you can't do anything now. It's like, hey, you know how you can play those cards? You can't now. I'm going to stop you from doing that. Counterspell, not my favorite. But I like... whatever encompasses the card, binding the binding contract, or the tempting contract, or Bucknard's Everfall Purse, where I go, I roll a d4 and get a treasure token, and then you can have the card, and you can roll a d4 and get a treasure token. Or, Smothering Tithe is really fun. It doesn't completely negate you or anything, but it makes me get treasure tokens. Tempting contract's also fun too, which is just like, do you want a treasure token? Then I can have a treasure token. Yeah. It's like evil group hug. Whatever that is. Yeah. I like the gay date card. Secret rendezvous. I draw three cards, you draw three cards. And then the other two players are like, the fuck? Yeah.
That's a wonderful commander card.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Chef kiss.
Yeah. Whatever that is, I love that. There's another card that...
plus Smothering Tithe.
Yeah. There's a card that I really like. It makes things really... I don't know. I like Plane Chase. Plane Chase is fun.
Mm-hmm.
I like random board effects.
This is very good.
It's good. It's a good time. What about you, Spencer?
Oh, I don't really know.
Why did you pick the question?
Big woman?
Yeah. I have an angel deck I really like playing.
I think I know what your favorite...
What is it?
I don't know what it's called, so Craig's just going to have to figure it out.
Okay.
I think it's just enchantments. It's just like, I'm going to play creatures, and then I'm going to... You're not going to like... give them a billion 1/1s, but you're going to give them keywords, and you're going to make them strong, and you're going to protect yourself, and then you're going to choose when you're going to fight. And then you'll get a win con, and then you'll go, okay, now I know how I'm going to win, and I'm going to make it so nobody can stop me.
That's the angel deck, yeah.
But it's also Edgar. Edgar will be like, here's some vampires, and mm-hmm. then I'm going to play this card so that whenever anybody takes damage, I'm going to gain life. Yeah. I'm going to create more vampires, and then I'm going to play this card, which is going to make all of them really strong. Mm-hmm. And now all I have to do is do this, and then I win.
Yeah.
I don't think that's just playstyle, really. I don't think that's like a type.
I guess you could call like an army deck. Sometimes those are things. Where most reason they think about it's like the key stables like Odric.
That's also like your Dritz soup. Deck.
Wow.
It's Slesnia, and mm-hmm. Slesnia does that a lot, too.
A bunch of little dudes.
Just a bunch of dudes. Yeah. But it can't be a bunch of tokens. It has to be like a bunch of dudes who are cool. Guys. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah. They have to be pretty cards.
The squad.
Yeah. Squad mm-hmm. deck.
Pretty and shiny is absolutely an archetype. Yeah. Sure, it has to be.
I think Spencer just needs to play Super Friends, and I think she'd like it a lot.
Mm. Mia's building one. Probably one of the most expensive decks we've ever built.
That's crazy.
But it's very cool.
I think you you really like Planeswalkers.
So, I do. Yeah. I do. I'm collecting all of them.
Those are rad. Very cool.
Yeah.
I like Graveyard Recursion a lot.
Hell yeah.
Yeah.
It's fun.
I like any way that's the way you're not supposed to play the game.
Hell yeah, dude.
Yeah.
Why you play a lot of control? Why do you do that?
I like control a lot.
Yeah.
Because I think it's a lot of fun. I think it's interesting. I think it's very difficult.
Mm-hmm.
Like it's quotes around everything, of course.
Yeah.
I think it's very easy to be red deck wins.
Yeah, yeah. Like
rush things down.
Mm-hmm.
But it's hard to. It's a kind of it's tempo, but to like a whole other level. Like you're constantly. The early game is your enemy,
mm-hmm.
and you're constantly on the defensive, and it's this creeping thing of I can sustain until like this giant wave comes, and you're like, now it's over.
It's cool because you're getting to interact with like everybody at the table. You just kind of need to know what's going on,
yeah.
And so whenever anybody does anything, you're keeping track of every interaction,
yeah.
And it's cool because it's control because you know you're controlling yeah. what everybody else can do, but it's in a way that's really fun because it's like you are shaping the battlefield yeah, in a way.
It's a fun way because control itself is very fun in 1v1. At least I find it to be. It can be very oppressive for sure.
Yeah.
But playing that playstyle, and this is true for red deck wins too, that both of those decks are really great when they have one opponent, but they fall really, really flat when you have three.
Yeah.
Because your burn spell doesn't do shit versus 120 mm-hmm. health.
Yep.
But nor does your counter spell do anything against 21 cards.
Yeah, exactly.
Right. But it's all about how do you become like quick allies? And mm-hmm. do I need to counterspell the kill spell? It's going to kill a creature that's not mine? Do I need to interact with that?
You get to
that's
allow about, death if you want.
Yeah, it's a fun. Lot about you get to. Yeah, it's about what it becomes less about. I mean, it's what you can control in the field. It's about what do you allow?
Yeah.
And how many things you can do that with. And I used to have a lot of players in my old pod that used to be very. Flavors of control, so it's fun to have like spell battles and stuff.
Oh, that's fun!
Like we set ourselves up to be really sustainable to the giant dragon deck at the table, and once the dragon deck was essentially sat on, it was about who's going to pull the trigger and then how many counterspells do you got to be the last man standing.
That's cool,
and it was a ton of fun.
That's super fun.
Yeah, I'm a huge fan of control.
So as much as like we like to shit on blue, but like you said, if a one-on-one commander game with both players being blue is so much fun because mm-hmm. it just feels like. You're just popping off on spells all yeah. the time, you know. Between any of the other colors, it's just a match of like who can outpower the other person.
Yeah.
But when it's like it's two blue decks against each other, it's like we're not even looking at life. Like we're just looking at what we have on the board and who's got spells. And eventually, one of us is going to get to a point where the other person has one.
Yeah.
There's no ifs. It's just like. I have to do this. I have to do this. I have to do this. And it feels like a wizard duel. Yeah. Like that's what two blue decks against each other feels like. It also
interacts in a way that I kind of described earlier where graveyard decks interact with the graveyard, which is not normally a place that it has interaction with.
Yeah.
I think control decks interact in the stack primarily.
Mm-hmm.
And when you're against a deck that is either a spellslinger or like another variant of control, you get even more precise control spells popping off that interact solely in the stack. So you can have things that are just like counterspell to counterspell. It's just going to interact with the cards that come out.
Yeah.
But then you can have like a counterspell that counterspells an ability.
That's
you can
cool.
have like sudden dismissal that you can play last. It counterspells everything on the stack.
Ugh.
Or you can have something that has split second and then
crazy.
The stack. So there's a lot of like, ways you try and like, can I counterspell you and then shut down the stack before you can counterspell me?
That's awesome.
It's all about how many cards you have in your hand. I mean, it's just a lot of fun because I think when you have a lot of creatures on the battlefield, all the knowledge is known.
Mm-hmm.
But it doesn't matter if my opponent has five lands in their hand. I have to look at it and go, what you got in your hand? And yeah. it could, you know, that's half the fun. You're like, I don't know what you have, but if I play something, I need to make sure that whatever you have in response, I can respond to.
Yeah.
Even if there's nothing.
Mm-hmm. God, that's cool.
It's
that's
a lot of fun. I love to live in fear.
Yeah. Yeah. Mia's always said since day one of, like, you guys playing Magic with us was that, like, she'd be like, I know how Rakdos works, Jacob. You have a gun. You're pointing it at everybody. And I'm like, I think that's like how I like to play the game. It's yeah. just like you're living in fear. I like to point the gun. Yeah. and be like, do the thing. Well, do it.
That's a lot of it is that control is great because I don't have to. The best thing about control is I also get to build the deck where I don't have a win con. Because it's like I'm going to hope that there's a Rakdos player that's going to murder everyone.
Yeah.
To, well, eventually the Rakdos player has two life.
That's how it goes. That's how our games always go, dude. It's always me fucking oppressing our other two, and then I'm like, Craig, and you're like, no, and I'm like, I can't fucking touch you, and then by the time I'm down, you're like, and I'm like, oh shit. Yeah,
it's actually two damage, baby.
Yeah.
But that's not worked out the last couple times, because Avacyn is dying destructive, most of the shit I have, and then his board gets way too fat, and yeah. I'm like, I can't bait.
Yeah.
Can't do nothing. I can't destroy nothing.
Stomp. Avacyn is not impossible, huge. Is the thing. Avacyn, no. I think everybody thinks, like all of our friends especially, think that, Avacyn's out. It's the fucking end of the world. And it's like, I have seen that deck fail more than it's won. Mm-hmm. Like, it pops off, definitely. But, I mean, there's some easy shit that gets rid of them. Like, it's yeah.
I think it's a fun deck because it is, we have a lot of very good cards that come out that warp the format. But really, we've not really had like a creature do that. That's not green.
Yeah.
And we used to have a ton of them. Every time a set would come out, we'd be like, "This is gonna destroy everything." Avacyn was that way, and it was all very fair magic. We don't have things like, I don't know, Elder Gargroth. It's like six mana does a billion things, and
yeah,
it's fucking crazy. Avacyn's a 9 mana spell. The bitch should win the game. She should say, "Enters battlefield, you win."
Mm-hmm. Pretty much.
You're paying that much, the game should be over.
Yeah.
But she comes from an era of magic that's just like, I have a creature, and this creature is so just generically good.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And I love that, because she'll warp. You can feel the impact of a card drop, and you're like, nothing works anymore. The game's shut off. We have to work with her. Sure, she's powerful, and you could exile at any moment, but like, that's it.
Yeah.
Avacyn dictates how the whole deck games be played.
I love that's the
same thing for like Grizzlebrands or, what is it? It's not Skitherix. I mean, Skitherix is one of them. But there's a little artifact that I have that you can spell sky, where you can
spell. I was gonna
redirect shit. Yeah. It's just the game changes so much because it's just like a really functional card.
Yeah,
but it's not exactly. Broken. And doesn't it's not like overvalued. It's just like a good card.
There's something about like in Magic because like I've played a lot of games. I think more often than not, I've played games where it's like people are winning. Not based on like, it's based off of the combo or the cards that they had in the moment, and the response to it wasn't good enough, so therefore they win.
Yeah.
But I love when the win is just, that guy is too strong, and we can't do anything, so we're dead. And it's like, that's cool as fuck.
The worst part of Avacyn is that she's an 8-8 and she's a commander. She'll beat me to death in 3, and that's just functionally wonderful.
Yeah, yeah.
There's a, the Praetors were that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
because we're in a time where we have 3 versions of every Praetor now.
Mm-hmm.
Before there was none. There was only 1, and whenever Nellish Norn dropped, that goes, you're like, well, you win.
Nothing will come in
and die. Everything is massive. Or God, old Jenga Taxus removes your hand size. So you're like, hand size is 0.
Yeah.
Pass, hand's gone.
Tyler made a deck that was all of the Praetors.
Yeah.
And we played it, and it was really funny. It was just funny to be like, wow, that they had like 3 things out, and it was like, we can barely play the game. Like, what are we supposed to do about this? It was crazy.
Game breaking.
Yeah. So wild.
I fucking love that game.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
It's pretty cool. There was something I was going to say about Avacyn. I can't remember what it was.
Was it that I won that game?
You did win that game. Yeah. No, you've won a lot with Avacyn.
I have.
Yeah, yeah. I'm truly trying to remove the prestige, because every time you're like, I'm going to play Avacyn, everybody's like, and it's like,
wait, no,
she's not that scary.
I can't remember if I did actually win that game.
Afraid of something, though.
Definitely is.
Because we've not really had like a true dragon deck at the table. Like Ur-Dragon, that's right up with an angel deck. Like, you know the deck's going to be, it's good.
Mm-hmm.
It's not breaking, but you know Avacyn's going to drop, and it's going to just be like, Who counterspell player?
That's the thing.
Who didn't counterspell the
opposite? I like it. I like it when she gets Avacyn out, and it's like, oh shit, like that's fine. Uh-huh. But it's like we haven't even played yet, and it's like, guys, we don't need to target Spencer because she's playing Avacyn.
Yeah.
Like, come on. Mm-hmm. Like, I get that there's some decks that are like that, but like,
I think I understand what we're saying.
Yeah. But when Avacyn comes out and it's a big deal, yeah. that's hype yeah. as fuck. I love that shit. That was that dinosaur deck that you made.
That was a good time.
Yeah. It's all, I love that. I love that deck. That was great.
All about the prestige and what they bring to the table.
Yeah.
The ancestors.
I feel like you get more upset when I play like Ghostly Prison than when I play.
Ain't that shit? It's like, now you can't, I have to pay to attack me.
I'm
like
I don't have enough mana to get Avacyn out yet.
Spell. Oh, what a goddamn spell. Goddamn, that I think that
the art's so good.
I've been burned by Imprison in the Moon way too many times.
Oh, yeah. That was such a shit fucking card.
It's balanced. That's great. You have a land.
It's balanced against goddamn red and black.
Oh, it's balanced against everything. It's the most broken card in Commander because your commander cannot go back to the command zone.
Yeah.
No.
It's like you're a land now. Get rid of it.
Yeah.
You don't have a commander anymore in the game. Yeah. You're like,
what? White and green and blue. Well, white and green have a lot of like, destroy target enchantments. Mm. Fucking black and red don't. No. Raphael goes into the moon. I'm like, well, I guess I'm.
But you do have destroy target permanents.
Yeah.
Which is your land.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah. I'll just get a.
Or you can sacrifice permanents?
Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm. Get a. What is that? It's not Firestorm. It's not Grapeshot. It's a
Starve Extinction?
There you go. That'll do it.
Let's destroy a land and kill everything on the field. Yeah. They just unbanned a red card that I'm so glad they unbanned. It's called Worldfire. Uh-huh. It kills everything and drops everyone's life to one. And the game resets, but you have one life.
So it's just the first person to
like, get everyone down.
That's fun.
That's so fun. So good. I love red so much. Quartzy asks, any advice/tips for doing one-on-one D&D? You know, one DM and one player. Was thinking of doing a bit of it with my partner since he has a character he really wants to play but no outlet for it. I personally think one-on-one D&D is super fun. Mm-hmm. There are dozens of us, dozens, who have played one-on-one. I've done most of my session zeros, like the Evenfall session zeros, I did one-on-one D&D for each player. Oh, and cool. It was so fun because we could do it in like a text chat, which was fun, but we could also do it in person. Mm-hmm. And it was just really like intimate narrative role play experience. Mm-hmm. And yeah, we've done it a few times. Mm-hmm. You're just not a big fan, but I love it. I do it all the time if I could. It's really fun. And it's super easy.
No.
Because you just have one person.
I think 1v1 really leads itself to mysteries or high drama.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. A lot of character or NPC oriented story based.
I think it'd be fun to run a pre-written with one player because they would approach the scenarios much differently.
That's true.
And I think that it would just overall go a lot more different, and you would just really get to sit in the story a lot more. It'd be like a single player video game where like, you know, you've got the story of the player characters and all that stuff, but when you've got one-on-one D&D and you've got a single person, it's like there's that narrative aspect that I think really, really comes through that I think would be really fun. I don't have any advice, so I haven't run it that much, but yeah.
We have the baby now.
We do indeed have the baby
now. Oh, are you clapping?
You doing the clap sync?
Why don't you do a clap sync?
Do the clap sync, Marcy.
Yeah.
No.
She said no.
No.
You want to talk?
Can you say hi?
Say hi.
Oh, eat.
Can you, hi.
Who's a?
No? All right.
There's a comment on the last episode of the podcast that said, what if we just had
there it is.
Marcy-centric podcast where it's just her and then us faintly in the background talking like a podcast.
She's like, hi.
It's primarily her little
and then
coos.
20 minutes later, hi.
yeah. Hi. Unknown Kobold asks, do you have a favorite endgame level monster you'd like to run?
That we run a lot of.
Or just there's an endgame monster, you're just like, that's fucking cool, I love that. Mm. I'd be honest, I love an ancient dragon.
Yeah, classic.
I don't know if you can... I love an ancient dragon. I think an ancient, just any dragon, is cool as hell. There's something so simple and neat about it, and they did a lot for dragons and fizzbins. So I'm just coming in and out, really. So
that's what you do sometimes.
For audio listeners, Marceline is moving Jacob's mic back and forth.
Yeah. Hopefully you can't hear her gripping the mic like that. So. Hi.
That's what everyone wanted.
What about you, Spencer? What's one you like to experience?
Experience?
Yeah.
Fuck with.
Like to experience.
Kind of like a Giga Strahd.
A Giga Strahd. I don't know.
You ever looked at the Monster Manual? Saw a really powerful monster and was like, that's cool. I like that.
That's cool. I don't know. We fought Tiamat. That was fun. But you say book. You trying to say book? Tiamat's up there.
The kitty?
Yeah, the kitty.
Yeah, she thought it was a kitty.
I love me some primordials. Like elementals. Like the big ones. Like the phoenixes. Like the leviathans.
Yes, those are so cool.
So good. The tempests.
Mm-hmm.
What about you, Secret?
Secret?
Secret. Lacey's in here. You have to yell. Oh, wait, never mind. You have Craig's mic.
Oh, I never thought about it, actually.
Yeah. Good.
Kill Murray Fuck.
I'm trying to think of like
Wisp of Air.
I can't actually think of a D&D monster right now.
A single one? Not one.
Not even the one that's in there.
No.
The abbreviation.
You know
what's
what?
The first thing coming to your mind right now?
Okay, I'm actually thinking about Yugen from Magic the Gathering. Oh.
Yugen.
It's Eugene.
Eugene or Yugen?
I mean myself because I always call it Eugene.
Yeah.
Ugin.
The vast majority of people actually call him Eugene, but Ugin is out. So.
Hey, kiddo, you better not be gunking up the mic audio right now.
She's like
Nicole Bolas.
Yep. Nicole Bolas. Yeah. Love that's his name.
What's his name in like the Philippines or like in what is it? It's his name in.
Quarter
Portuguese is it's just something balls.
Oh,
because I didn't bother to translate it. Balls. So it's just something balls. You like great.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Come to mama.
Hi.
Can you say mama?
Ugin's good. Ugin's not only a dragon but also a spirit.
Yeah, he is because he died. He got by his brother, and he went to the spirit realm. He's like, I'm actually not dead.
He was never alive.
I'm alive in a minute.
Yeah, really. I've never seen him alive.
He's alive in the lore.
Yes.
And he's like that frog.
He's only cool when he dies.
He was brought into existence.
He got a planeswalker spark, and Nicol Bolas was like,
oh, yeah.
And then he killed him, and then he was like,
know,
oh,
nerd.
I got my...
No, I was just going to meme. I'm sorry. I was going to say...
what's that?
Because our house always calls it Nico Bulbous, and that's what I've been thinking of the whole time.
Nicol Bulbous?
A lot of
Bulbous Nichols?
I've heard
someone in your house is calling it that.
I think we called him Flipple Bolus. Because there's that famous Nicol Bulbous rabbit.
Oh, yeah,
he flips. So
yeah, Flipple Bolus.
But I don't call everyone Bulbous.
That's what's been stuck in my head.
That's great. You know, there are some versions of him that the man is a little packed.
Oh.
He's a little packing some heat. Mm-hmm. He's weird looking. He's awfully human sometimes.
Wow. Yes.
Nicol Bulge. Yeah.
There,
the demon bimbo of Yeet Street asks, Jacob, how's little Marcy doing?
She's great.
She's doing
here.
She's doing great. She's grabbing a bunch of cards and
she turns one in like 2 weeks.
Yep.
Yeah. Oh God.
She says hi all the time.
Hi.
Say hi.
She's on cue. Doesn't want to walk.
Nope. Will not.
Yeah, you're telling us that.
Sits her.
You saw her walk, and then she was like, "I just
know." I saw her stand unassisted, and then I tried to point it out to Jacob, and she went, "Nope," sat right back down.
Yeah.
She actually, when I was watching her, she got up and walked away from me to that little toy stand thing because I think I was moving too much and
she
made her
like,
mad.
She was like,
"She's like, I'm out.
I'm getting out of here."
And then she started to cry.
I gotta leave.
Overstimulating me.
Yeah.
Help. Andrew Dice Tray asks, how many breath mints equal a brushing of the teeth?
Oh my god.
None.
None.
You gotta brush your teeth.
Zero?
Zero.
You think it's zero?
Zero.
Like, equal a brushing of the teeth.
Okay.
But your
not
mouth,
even, not
okay.
even a month?
Your mouth isn't gonna feel clean.
A month? A tooth? Wait, 0.1. 0.1% of brushing your
clean.
Teeth?
Clean. I thought you were talking about 0.1% of a mint. I was like, why would you say less
one
than?
Mint could be equal to 0.1% of brushing your teeth.
A cleaner? I don't
Not cleaner, no, just cleaning your teeth. You don't think it does anything? No. You think doing nothing is cleaner than putting a mint in your mouth?
Okay, it's going to maybe make your breath smell better. But
that's
it's
at not least 0.1%.
It's not going to make your mouth feel clean.
It's at least 0.1% because brushing your teeth makes your mouth smell good.
She's after those cards. She wants those initiative cards.
All right, you want to read the questions? All right. Hi.
I don't know.
Two or three.
Two or three is equivalent to brushing your teeth?
No. No. I would feel okay if I had two or three breath mints in my mouth.
You wish we couldn't.
It definitely does not clean your... No. It definitely does not clean your teeth.
I should just say them.
But it makes you feel a little clean. It doesn't do anything. It doesn't do much.
If I was in a scenario, you know, the airport lost my luggage. I got whatever this kiosk has. And yeah. It's Andy's mints and a paper towel roll I can go to the bathroom with real fast. Hey. I'd probably squeeze my teeth.
Yeah.
If I eat three, and I'd be like, you know what? This was a vice until I brush my teeth at some point.
Right? Yeah, exactly.
They don't have any of those little Colgate wisp things in there. You're just like, a few of those. Feel pretty good.
Mints? That's what you chose?
Not Altoids?
That's what I was thinking about. Chocolate? Yeah, I'm the chocolate.
I've never heard of Andy. What the hell is Andy?
I'm in the bathroom stall doing this and eating chocolate.
Dude, sometimes Craig is like, he's like 80 years old. Like he just whips something I've never heard of before. And I'm like,
you have to have seen Andy's mitts somewhere.
I've never heard of that.
It did not register in Andy's my brain. Mets.
Fucking got him!
I gave you that to contribute.
If you had an entire spoonful of garlic, how many Altoids do you think it would take to eliminate the smell?
I would need a silver bullet. I hate garlic so fucking
really?
Much.
Really?
I hate it.
Whoa! You don't like garlic?
It lingers in every pore of my mouth.
Because it's delicious.
It's everywhere.
It's amazing.
Even a little bit. And I have to brush my teeth after.
It tastes and smells.
I can taste it forever.
Incredible.
No, it smells terrible.
We also don't like Ed's cilantro,
pizza
though.
The other day, we asked for garlic on it, and they put so much.
It was a little excessive.
A garlic pizza. No, it's the greatest thing I ever had. I think I like garlic a little too much.
I think I don't know if the super veggies or the super greens have garlic in them.
I think they do.
Ooh. It got all my rice last night, and I was like, my mouth is gross.
Super greens are good though.
I give you this mic and you say D's nuts one more time.
I just wanted to say that Jacob is correct.
What about garlic?
Let's go,
about
dude. Garlic. Yeah. Let's go, dude.
We also have the same opinion on mayonnaise.
Yeah, the same with us. I really like mayo. I said the other day, I said, and Emma has told me this before, which was, why is the best part of the McChicken the mayo? And you two were like,
I take it off.
And yeah, you take it off. And Lacey was like, you're right. And I was like,
it's too much.
Somebody's on my side.
It's excessive.
Riley asks, if you had to fight your...
Oh my God, please.
Riley asks, if please. You had to fight as yourself in Mortal Kombat...
Oh. I thought that's not what I was going to ask.
Would you rather face 100 beasts? I can't fucking say it.
Beasts?
If you had to fight as yourself in Mortal Kombat, would you rather face 100 bee-sized Nicolas Cages or one Nick-sized Nick Cage-sized bee?
Wow. Probably the one bee.
But they're Nick Cages. You can just step on them. They can fly.
There's too many of them.
You could just step on them.
You're the household expert on that.
I actually was going to show you a TikTok instead.
A big old bee would be scary as fuck. They can lift like a billion. What's the beginning of the bee movie? They can lift like 10 times their weight or something.
Wow. I assume I'm gonna die in both those scenarios.
The bee would.
I assume I'm gonna die in both those scenarios. No,
Craig just dropped his mic.
I'm gonna die in both scenarios, so I just want the big one.
You could fight 100 bee-sized Nick Cages.
Yeah, I think I could.
Yeah, you just they'd why run at you, show me this? And you just go.
And why does that look like your dad?
I'd trap him.
Get out of here. Him.
What is happening over there?
Don't show me.
Going on? What are you doing? What are you showing
this
him?
This is a podcast.
That's really scary. It's a guy who is Nicolas Cage, but it's like a face app thing.
It's on his skin.
And his face is really horrifying. What? What is this? Oh, I scrolled too far.
Oh.
Here you go. I brought it back.
I thought the question was going to be, If you could fight your significant other, who would win?
Oh, that's interesting. Because
I would win.
Here's the parameters. Are we fighting at our hardest? And are we fighting with the intent to kill? Like, I hate you and you have to die?
No, just...
Is it just pure body? Because I let her kill me, if not.
Aw, no. You'd let me kill you?
Well, never to death. Just a fun little sport.
I'd kick your ass.
Yeah.
Craig would win.
Really?
Craig's known to wrestle out in the mud.
Yeah, I know why. You mean like,
I've been known.
Get down. You have the rope. I don't know why, but I imagine you have like a...
Oh, like a lasso?
It has been proven several times.
Damn. Nice. Hell yeah, dude. Wow. That's awesome. This is revenge because one time he fucking said something one time, and I don't remember what it was on the podcast. We both stopped. You're like, oh, you two just both blushed right now. And I'm like, you fucking ass. I'm going to get you back for this one day. This is it. This is it. This is it. If it was pure physicality, uh-huh. I'm like double your entire mass.
Yeah.
So no. But I don't think I'd live with myself.
I think I'd win.
Why? What would you do?
I don't know.
You have no plan. You just think you'd win.
I think I'm stronger than you are.
Let's pull this table over here right now and do a wrestle. Let's fucking do it. Let's see. Because I know that's false.
Yeah.
That is absolutely false.
Okay.
All right. What if we save it for next week we can have an arm wrestling episode?
Let's do it right now. No balls.
No.
Nope.
Yeah. I'll save your prey.
Yeah. Week to train.
No, this is a fucking challenge.
No.
You don't get any time.
All right. All right.
Are you kidding me? Yeah. No, I have to give you at least an advantage. I have to get. Yeah. I'll hold her. No, I can do it. Are you serious right now?
The motherly instinct.
What are you trying to prove right now? What are you doing? No, let me hold her. Let me hold her.
I'm gonna sell you a few food. Yeah.
Are you serious about this?
Yeah.
Craig, cut us in.
All right.
Why are you laughing? Are you scared?
Competitors.
You afraid? Why?
On your mark.
You're going
to
win.
Right. On go.
Okay.
3, 2, 1, go.
You're not even doing anything, are you? You bastard.
Damn it.
To all the people who think that I go easy on Spencer during D&D.
He doesn't.
Fucking don't. All right. If there's a challenge involved, I will not. I will not. Spencer's just really good at D&D, to be honest.
Oh, thank you. But not at arm wrestling.
Nope.
Damn.
Nope.
All right.